Well, this is a deadly stretch of I-25 where multiple people have been killed in wrong-way driver crashes, despite those signs that you see here. Now, those signs are getting a smart makeover, and they will be anything but a typical metal rectangle. It was one of the worst wrong-way driver crashes in New Mexico state history. Back in 2006, sheriff's deputies say Dana Papps was driving the wrong way on I-25 near Santa Fe when he slammed into a minivan, killing a family of five. It's crashes like this new detection technology aims to stop. This past legislative session, Senator Worth of Santa Fe helped allocate $200,000 to begin the pilot project.
We keep seeing these happen over and over again, and it's just mind-boggling.
First, drivers will see a lighted sign like this one. Then, through radar detection, police will receive a picture of the vehicle and location.
Other states have done this successfully and really reduced the number of fatalities.
Like in Arizona, where similar thermal technology has been used on Phoenix Highway since 2018, one of the first pilot projects in the country. The Arizona Department of Transportation reports it has successfully detected more than 60 wrong-way vehicles. The new signs here will first go up on I-25 and the old Pecos Trail exit, and at the intersection of Highway 285 and I-25.
I've served in the legislature now for 15 years, and during that time, six people have lost their lives on this particular stretch of I-25.
By the end of 2020, the Department of Transportation hopes to have signs in many more parts of the state, including, we'll pull those up on your screen right now, all of I-25 from Cochiti to Glorieta, and then all of I-40 from Edgewood to Klein's Corners, and then a couple of state routes as well and a couple of state roads. So in total, the project is expected to cost anywhere between $2.5 million and $3.5 million. Live in Santa Fe, Shelby Cashman, KOAT Action 7 News.